A man allegedly refused to pull over. He claimed he's a sovereign citizen.
They don't recognize the government's authority.
I don't know what the hell law book you're reading, man, but it doesn't apply to me. I'm going in.
No, you're not going in.
Don't touch me.
Why have your policy allowed our Magna Carta, our rights, our common law to be ignored?
My fellow Canadians, I address you today as your Queen, Commander-in-Chief, and head of government.
That's not actually the Queen of Canada. In fact, she's a woman named Romana Didulo, a YouTuber and minor internet celebrity who's declared herself Queen. This might seem like just more delusional nonsense on the internet, but Didulo has over 70,000 followers. More worryingly, she's tried to incite them into violence against anyone facilitating COVID vaccinations for children. She's not just some lone eccentric with a webcam. She's part of a fringe ideology known as the sovereign citizen movement, which has surged during the pandemic.
All of the evidence to prove that coronavirus is an absolute pandemic hoax, that you are operating illegally and you are committing crimes against humanity.
Their bizarre anti-government conspiracy theories have spread like wildfire. Sovereign citizens believe that they're above the law, that their ideology is the key to fighting against the so-called COVID plandemic, and who are showing a dangerous potential for violence.
So we're here at Edinburgh Castle, we're taking our power back today. We have seized the building, we are here, we are peaceful, we are sovereign people.
In August 2021, a group of anti-lockdown protesters stormed Edinburgh Castle in Scotland, shouting that they were seizing the castle to fight tyranny and restore the rule of law. They claimed their justification for this was Article 61 of Magna Carta. That's a 13th century legal document that guaranteed the rights of a specific group of 25 English barons to seek redress from the king if they felt they were being governed unjustly.
This belongs to the people. This is Article 61 of Magna Carta.
Article 61 itself was removed from Magna Carta within a year. And although Magna Carta is a crucial part of how English law developed, it's not some magical document that supersedes laws of ownership, taxation, or public order.
There's only two things the government fears: Article 61 and unity of the people.
It seems like it's almost like a deliberate misreading of the Magna Carta from history, but also in the US of the rules around the kind of 1868 legislation as well.
This is very much the essence of sovereign citizen ideology. They take random bits of legal and historical jargon and spin it into an argument where, by simply declaring themselves sovereign, they supposedly become above the law, operating under an entirely different set of rules to everyone else.
Sovereign citizens believe that they, not judges, juries, or law enforcement, get to decide which laws to follow and which to ignore, and they don't think they should have to pay taxes.
Based on these fraudulent arguments, sovereign citizens try to claim the government is illegitimate and insist that they themselves are the true source of authority, often even issuing their own ID documents.
Is it everything you need here to understand that I don't need a license, registration, or any documentation to travel from point A to point B? Is it a right that has been preserved by the Supreme Court and the law of the land?
Pre-pandemic, it was quite a quaint conspiracy movement, so it was a lot of people trying to, you know, use this to get out of parking tickets, speeding fines.
What was once an obscure ideology has become supercharged during the pandemic, finding new followers in the conspiracy-obsessed anti-lockdown movements that believe that coronavirus is some kind of plot against the people.
The pandemic and COVID accelerated this movement, not because of the pandemic per se, but because of the government mandates that came along with the pandemic. And there was a certain segment of people who did not want to follow the government mandates, and the sovereign citizen ideology, the rhetoric, the ideas within that movement served as, in their minds, a good excuse to not have to follow the mandates.
From North America and Europe to Australia, New Zealand, and Singapore, extremists have latched onto the ideology in the misguided belief that it gives them the means to fight against vaccines, lockdowns, and other COVID-related restrictions.
Human beings from COVID, by the way.
Yeah,
dad
died as well. Death happens.
Hey! In the UK, sovereign citizens have launched physical attacks on COVID testing centres. forcibly shut down vaccination clinics, and the leader of the opposition Labour Party has been hounded on the street by mobs screaming about COVID restrictions, common law, and Magna Carta.
Why have your party allowed our Magna Carta, our rights, our common law to be ignored?
Peace constables, peace officers, common law constables. These are the names sovereign citizens give their own self-appointed police forces, whose authority, they claim, trumps that of the actual cops.
You're lawfully empowered to employ other members of the public as peace officers and to detain and arrest anyone you see breaching the public peace.
That means the movement calls on them to enforce their own version of reality.
You don't have to arrest yourself. Yeah. And if you do something, you can say you need to get them.
I don't understand what he's trying to say there.
Some are even taking their own zip ties to protest to carry out arrests.
Can you explain to me what this is?
This is a PO, peace officer. I have tie wrap and my card.
You have hand ties?
Yeah. Tie wrap.
Who gave you hand ties?
I took it by myself.
You brought them yourself?
Exactly.
Of course, none of these pretend constables are actually police officers, any more than someone doing cosplay is actually a superhero. But as tempting as it might be to dismiss the sovereign citizens as a bunch of noisy but relatively harmless idiots, that would only be half right.
Don't discount or ignore these people, because they're willing to kill and be killed for these beliefs.
Since late 2021, a group of hardliners within the movement, calling themselves Alpha Team Assemble, have been holding combat training sessions in the UK, supposedly preparing themselves for militant direct action against the state.
For anyone doubting the Alpha Men Assemble, do not. These people are true. These people are fighting for our children and our futures.
This posturing has got the authorities concerned. Sovereign citizens are routinely expressing violent fantasies about a so-called Nuremberg 2.0 trial, where the supposed architects of the plandemic will be put on trial for treason, genocide, or serious crimes against humanity, and executed.
Police working undercover since April say they earned the trust of alleged anti-government sovereign citizens and were able to foil their alleged plans to kill cops.
Once the first kidnapping and execution was accomplished, they would be compelled to keep repeating their actions, kidnapping and killing multiple officers.
I object to the entire proceedings of this court.
The sovereign citizen practice of trying to enforce their own version of the law can clearly lead in dangerous directions. In 2010, police officers in Arkansas stopped a car driven by Jerry Kane, a sovereign citizen who gave seminars teaching people that they don't need to pay tax. Kane's 16-year-old son drew an AK-47 and murdered the two officers.
Two cops are dead, I was in the ditch. They're both dead now.
Law enforcement comes in contact with them fairly regularly because a lot of the sovereigns aren't following traffic laws, and so they get pulled over, and that can be an especially dangerous time for a police officer.
And Terry Nichols, one of the masterminds of the Oklahoma bombing, which killed 168 people, was heavily inspired by sovereign citizen ideas. The FBI classes sovereign citizens as one of the most serious domestic terrorism threats facing the US. One estimate put the number of hardcore sovereigns at 100,000, with three times that number in the broader movement.
This is something that law enforcement around the country is worried about, simply because, again, they never know when they might encounter these people just simply by doing their jobs.
The anti-vax sovereign citizens already have blood on their hands. In September 2021, a group of sovereign citizens in Ireland burst into a hospital ICU ward to rescue an elderly patient, a fellow sovereign citizen who had COVID-19.
It's all your choice, Joe.
Yes.
If you stay here, they're gonna fucking kill you, Joe.
Yes.
These people, they're not going to help you.
Here, please.
It's okay, I have my rights, because you are killing people.
Citing their usual arguments about common law, they removed the man against the advice of medical staff.
Steven, I'm very worried about you. And I want you to stay. What he's saying is wrong and very dangerous. And I think he's endangering your life.
The man later died.
Here is a direct link between someone motivated by sovereign citizen ideologies and kind of the blending of anti-vaccine ideologies as well to kind of push someone towards making a decision that in the end was fatal towards them. So that really does show the danger of people being swayed by those with sovereign citizen beliefs as well.
One of the trademark strategies the sovereign citizens use to intimidate and harass their perceived enemies is a technique known as paper terrorism. That's where sovereign citizens inundate their targets with a flood of threatening legal documents in an attempt to bully them into submission.
Paper terrorism is essentially creating members of the sovereign citizen movement, creating their own writs, creating their own kind of legal notices, and serving people who they deem to be offenders.
Now, the new wave of sovereign citizens have adopted this tactic in their quest to fight the so-called plandemic.
So if you're a UK Medical Alliance, which is all about the other UK Alliance of Medical Freedom of Alliance, the Declaration for the Protection of Children,
right?
Motu Proprio, you've probably not heard this one. Well, the Pope is head of the businesses in the across the world.
With many embracing the strategy as their great hope in stopping the COVID vaccine altogether. This has led to them targeting schools, courtrooms and hospitals, along with scientists, government officials and other individuals associated with the vaccination rollout with their bogus legal papers.
Paper terrorism is an old sovereign citizen tactic from the 90s, where basically if you inundate people with enough phony and fraudulent lawsuits, it intimidates them into changing the law or changing rules.
And the only way this strategy of paper terrorism ever works is by wearing down their opponents until they eventually give up. But that's clearly not going to happen when it comes to their ultimate goal here of stopping the global rollout of coronavirus vaccines. Already, there are signs of growing frustration within the movement at the failure of this paper terrorism to bear fruit, fueling calls for militants for more radical action.
They see the world in a completely different way now. It's no longer just a case of single issues such as vaccine mandates, mask mandates. They now view that as one facet of a much larger problem around the global masters who are, you know, pulling everyone straight. So, because these people have had their worldview fundamentally changed, they're not going to stop.
And with those lost down the rabbit hole of COVID conspiracies becoming ever more detached from reality and convinced that they're a law unto themselves, there are growing concerns about where all this is heading.